So there were old barns here at one time, and they're just putting new ones up?
We're putting new things up.
This has only been newly looked good, right?
Yeah.
That's the remains of the old steading there.
Oh, okay.
That's on the way down.
Oh, okay.
And a little bit to rebuild that. We're going to walk around the back,
aren't
we? That's all right. So it's a fairly big house.
There were a lot of people in the house. extended family.
Inside it's a gay old house. Like it's really neat.
Is that right?
But it's really neat. I go to it.
This is where my grandfather worked here at Slacks.
Oh, aye.
And he was a horseman.
Oh, I see.
They slept in the bothies, you know, the chammer as we could call it here, the chamber, the chammer.
Right.
And he had to sleep in the stable. He slept up here and the horses were down there.
Is that right? Keep them warm at night.
But that's what my grandfather used to tell me, that he worked at Slacks.
Wow.
But he wasn't born here, I don't
think.
150, that's a lot. It's a big farm.
No, it's definitely.
No, that's just
the way the size of falls a fair and through this way.
Take an average around here.
For back then, it would have been a lot to work the old ways.
That's what it was. Farmer and maybe a man, maybe and some of that place.
But this is great cattle country.
Oh yeah.
You see, when we demarked Moyd, that was the biggest weekly cattle market in all of Britain.
Yeah, your dad was the guy at the market, right?
They used to send the beef.
Kindness, all those fields will be on it.
You're a big landowner then, aren't you?
Well, we've 12 houses. We've 18 farms.
Are you 18 farms?
I think it's 18. Wow. but you get it. But that's a lot of every single one of our farms in my time in cattle and cattle, you see, took a lot of money to buy in cattle. Died up a lot of money, you know. That's Southfield.
Oh, I see, yes.
Yeah, you're finished swinging with Bobby Forsyth.
Oh, no, back to Bobby Forsyth.
He's a lovely son.
He's a great character.
So I left the school and get to work at the
Hamlet. The school, that's the school. That's the word for the school.
Oh, okay.
Because we've got a language of our own.
I found that out. We went to a comedy act last night. I couldn't have to understand half of what they were saying. But this is all Slacks land over here and back in here too, or?
Yes,
and Bruce Hill's just behind that. It's beautiful land. Like you say, when he came to Guelph, I mean, what he left was probably a lot better.
That's what Jimmy was scratching his head at. They're good. And their granduncle Jimmy is staying with them here. I was with them kids in Canada, across the coast. We don't look across the coast, they never get that far. Over the And it was 1911. I was working in New York for the Daily Express in 1967. I went up to see them. There was 9 and 10 still.
But you never would have met Jimmy, would you?
No.
Because he died in 1942 or something like that.
Even Arthur was 80 by then.
Yeah. His son, you mean? Yeah.
So, and then the second generation, there was one that was a pilot in the Air Force, and he came here and he spent his leave with us in Maud. He couldn't get him to Canada. Yeah. So they were just, this is just a generation that's going to do it. And they just went to see Father came for I was asked to speak to the family for 2 and 10. And there was 125 of them, but they were
very well.
But the youngest things were the ones that were most interested and wanted to know, like your generation.
Yeah.
And beyond, they wanted to know, what place is this Barron that you come?
Well, nobody knew about these things until I looked it up, they knew about you, and Kathy McPhee put me in contact with you originally, and they're fascinated by all this. They knew there was a farming background north of Aberdeen, that's all they knew. They didn't know the places, or...
This is New Deer. Yeah. This is a parish in Udea and the village in Udea. Mm-hmm. Maud is a village, but it's within the parish in Udea.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So we don't have a parish. We're just in between Udea and Old Udea. Mm-hmm.
So was your grandfather Arthur born here too?
He worked. It's slagged, but you've got him down. It's born somewhere else, I think.
I can't remember your grandfather. I know Jimmy was born here. But they lived over at the Bruce Hill Farm, though. I think the mother's family was here, so that's probably why he was born here. Yeah.
That's the family owned here and owned Bruce Hill. Upper Ironside.
Broom Hill.
Broom Hill.
Yeah. Little White Hill. White Hill.
I've been here all my life, I was born just in the community, just doing that tree over there, and
I say,
for the impact of Chipfield,
And then across here, we've got the only kind of mountain in the northeast here, that's Benahee.
Okay. A lot of windmills here now, they take advantage.
You'll see, if you've been up to the top of the hill, you'll get back.
We're going to Bruce Hill now.
Aye.
Meet you over there.
But that's a good farm with Slacks, like a grand farm. Good land with it. It's a good farm.
Yeah, it looks beautiful, yeah.
But they would have cattle.
I was saying, every farm, when I was a young chap,
if he was alone, that's a boy. If he was alone.
I've been based in English too.
No, never mind.
I understand that part.
every farm, they all had around about one beast. If it was 150 acres, they would use 150 beasts.
Is that right?
If it was 80 acres, they would have 80 beasts.
That's interesting.
And there would have been some small ones, calves or young beasties, and some bigger ones.
They always kept the number the same as the number of acres.
Beast per acre was round about for every farm. He was doing well if he was keeping a beast an acre.
We call cattle beasts.
Beasts. That's funny.
That's the kind of beast that you're thinking about. That's just 10 beasts in the park.
Was it mostly, I guess it's different cattle now, but when they came over, they used Aberdeen Angus, is what they used.
Angus, you see, was the breed at that time.
Now it's a mixture of different various.
They kind of get out, and then coming back a wee bit new. I've seen here, and I've been in America, and we get crossing that train from Chicago to Seattle, and there's a lot of cattle there. Black cattle.
Aberdeen
Angus cattle in the America.
Aberdeen Angus.
You see a menu if you need a steak or something, it's Angus steak. Is that Aberdeen Angus?
No, that's what
just got Angus steak.
They even have that at Harvey's in Canada. It's called Angus burger. But that's what the Barons had in Paisley Road there, the farm. They had Aberdeen Angus all the time. That's all they had. The Barons, Jack's family too. It's near Toronto, about an hour west of Toronto. It's called Guelph. Guelph, Ontario.
We've been in a place here, Woodstock.
Oh, yeah, that's the other side of us, towards London, That's about 45 minutes from us.
Year or two ago, was in Toronto once, and we get out of that area, and right. Quebec, and
oh, yeah.
Montreal.
You get around.
Oh,
well, you got land over there, too?
I worked like a slave for 20 years ago. I was working, and built this thing up, and built it up with a degree across there. Mm-hmm. Did a lot of work. Like, never stopped working, right in the Barrens. I was kids, they were growing up. Like, about 20 years ago, I started taking holidays. So I've had a lot of holidays since. I've actually been three times around the world.
That's good. So we're going to meet at Bruce still then?
Aye.